The following program may contain coarse language, violence, nudity, mature subject matter, or scenes which may not be suitable for all viewers. Viewer discretion is advised.
This is the Exxon Broadcast Network, broadcasting worldwide on broadcast affiliates and satellite program providers, including CNN Broadcast Network, Sirius Satellite Network, Star Media, Good News Radio Network, Angel Broadcast Network, Wiki Broadcast Network, and WPBN-TV. For more information on the X-Zone Broadcast Network, visit us at www.xzbn.net.
Hi, this is Rob McConnell, and I invite you to join me on Turquoise Radio for the X-Zone Radio Show, a place where people dare to believe and dare to be heard. After 21 years of paranormal TV and radio, thousands of celebrity interviews, and millions of worldwide supporters, I am very excited to bring my show to Turquoise Radio, where together we'll investigate the world of the paranormal to the science of parapsychology and all topics in between. Check out the website at turquoiseradio.com for showtimes. The X-Zone Radio Show with yours truly, Rob McConnell, on Turquoise Radio. And I'll see you in the X-Zone.
AVS Media
Tower. Papa Hotel, Lima Echo November, radio check.
Papa Echo November, good afternoon, Richard Pye.
Good afternoon, Redo 5 as well, Papa Echo November.
The X-Zone Radio and TV show is largely an opinion talk show. All opinions, comments, or statements of fact expressed by Rob McConnell's guests are strictly their own and are not to be construed as those of the X-Zone Radio and TV show or in any manner endorsed by Rob McConnell, Relmar McConnell Media Company, Talkstar Radio Network, its affiliated stations, or employees.
All Hit Radio. Welcome to the X Zone, a place where fact is fiction and fiction is reality. Now, here's your host, Rob McConnell.
He was born in the summer of his 27th year, coming home to a place he'd never been before. He left yesterday behind him. You might say he was born again. You might say he found the key for every door. When he first came to the mountains, his life was far away. On the road, hanging by a song. But the string's already broken, and he doesn't really care. It keeps changing fast, and it don't last for long. If the Colorado Rocky Mountain High, I've seen it.
And welcome back to the X-Zone, everyone. My name is Rob McConnell, coming to you from our studios in Hamilton, Ontario, Canada. Worldwide toll-free, 1-800-610-7035. Email X-Zone at xzoneradiotv.com. On MSN Messenger, xzoneradiotv at hotmail.com. And our website, www.xzoneradiotv.com. And now, X-Zone Nation, you can listen to the X-Zone Radio Show in high-definition stereo at www.xzoneradiotv.com/listen.htm. My guest this hour is a lady we've had the pleasure of having on the show before. Her name is Gwilda Wiyaka, and we're going to be talking to Gwilda about her new book. It's entitled "So We're Still Here, Now What?" That's a great question. Now, Gwilda is the founder, director, and owner of Path Home Shamanic Art Schools, a Colorado State-certified occupational school that trains and certifies shamanic practitioners and instructors. As the preceptor for the University of Colorado School of Medicine, she provides information to medical doctors on the modern interface between shamanism and allopathic medicine. Gwilda has studied shamanism for 40 years, has been a practitioner for 30, and a teacher of the shamanic arts since 1996. She conducts workshops and seminars throughout the world, and she is inspired as a speaker, singer, and songwriter. Joining me now from Colorado is Gwilda. And Gwilda, I want to thank you so much for joining us today. How are things in Rocky Mountain High, Colorado?
Well, it's high and rocky.
Gwilda, last time you and I talked was before the end of the Mayan calendar, and there were so many misconceptions about what was happening. When we come back from this commercial break, I'd like to get your feed on what the true meaning to, as seen by a shamanic person of your experience, to what was misinterpreted as the end of the Mayan calendar. So please stand by. Exonation, Gwilda Wiyaka is my special guest. She's the author of So We're Still Here, Now What? And Gwilda will be my guest this hour here in the X-Zone as we continue investigating the world of the paranormal and the science of parapsychology with yours truly, Rob McConnell. I'll be back on the other side of this commercial break. And don't forget, you can now listen to the X-Zone radio show in high-definition stereo at www.xzoneradiotv.com/listen.htm. And we welcome Turquoise Radio as a broadcast affiliate of the X-Zone Radio TV show. I'll be back on the other side with Gwilda as we continue here in the X-Zone. Don't go away. Modern Esoteric, Beyond Our Senses by Brad Olson, consummates the lifeology story about where humanity originates. It is the lost continents, the primitive wisdom, the mythos of creation, and the rethinking of ancient history as we are taught in academia. There is much more to the story than what we have been told. As this is the first book in the Esoteric series, Modern Esoteric starts at the beginning of time and accelerates up to this modern age. Future Esoteric is book two in the series and takes a forward-looking position ahead of today with an open and honest examination of the ET issue and various unexplained phenomena. To discover the writings of author Brad Olson, visit www.bradolson.com. That's www.bradolson.com. Named one of the world's greatest psychics, Elizabeth Joyce is now giving readings worldwide via Skype. Elizabeth Joyce is recognized for her clairvoyant ability to help find missing persons, her analysis of dreams, past life regression work, mediumship, and her accurate predictions. Elizabeth has been a frequent guest on the X-Zone radio show with yours truly, Rob McConnell, now for several years. For an appointment with Elizabeth Joyce, call 201-934-8986 or Skype at elizabeth.joyce. And for more information, you can always visit Elizabeth Joyce online at www.new-visions.com.
Have a disease that you would like to alleviate through a natural means? Have you been contacted by angels, ghosts, or even extraterrestrials and want to validate these experiences? Or would you simply like to speak with someone who can help you find your life's purpose? I'm Dr. Joseph Mara, and I'm offering my services free of charge for first-time clients contacting me during the month of April. These free consultations include angel card readings, guided meditations, life coaching, and energy healing. If you have always wanted to explore these types of experiences but were skeptical or simply could not afford them, then take advantage of this free special offer. Contact me through my website, aguidinglight, spelled LITE.com, to schedule your consultation today. Until then, I offer you love, light, and laughter.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home.
And welcome back, everyone. Gwilda Wiyaka is my special guest. Her website is www.gwildawiyaka.com. And Gwilda, thanks very much for joining us. It's always great talking to you. But as I discussed earlier, just as we did a tease for this segment, the last time you and I were on the show, we were talking a little bit about the end of the Mayan calendar 2012, and you know, so many people were talking about doom and gloom. What really happened?
Well, it's pretty interesting what really happened, and it wasn't like a mystery if you look at it long term. What really happened is we moved from one world influence into another, and by mm-hmm. world, I mean time frame according to the Mayan calendar. So we had been in the fourth world since 3,114 before Christ, and then as we moved into 1212, we've been moving into a time when the matrix or energetic frequency that was holding the fourth world together mm-hmm. was starting to disintegrate to make room for the fifth world. And the fourth world, it's the energy that was there, was pretty much about polarization and exploitation, and that's kind of what was supported by that time. And now the fifth world is one of unity and synergy, which is really kind of fun. But as when an old time dies, it has to literally die,
sure.
and the new time has to take over. So it's a pretty exciting time to be alive.
I think so. And is this the era that the hippies were talking about way back in the 60s, the age of Aquarius, make love, not war, everybody coming together and realizing that there's more to this planet than hate and war?
Yes, I really think it is. They talked about the dawning of the age of
yes.
Aquarius, and that's exactly what we're moving into. In conjunction with all the shifts that the Mayan calendar predicted, we're moving into the age of Aquarius, which is, we're in the band of the photon band when we get into the age of Aquarius, which is a band of extremely high frequency particles that exist out in the universe that we pass through periodically. The last time we were here was the time of the myths and legends of the garden, mm-hmm. and that was in the age of Leo. So that was 12,000 years ago.
You know, you won't probably remember this because you're a very young lady, but In the 60s, like it was a fascinating time. We had Haight-Ashbury, we had Woodstock, we had the new music that rocked the world, the Beatles, the Rolling Stones, the Dave Clark Five, Jefferson Airplane, all this wonderful music. Was this a preparation period for us to get into the age of Aquarius and where we are today?
I really think so. I think a lot of those people came as kind of like forerunners.
Mm-hmm.
And you notice that when they started with rock and roll, we were getting into a more native kind of beat.
Exactly.
Which kind of helps with kind of a trance-like state. And these people were tapping into information and singing about it and
yeah.
writing about it and really bringing it through. And I think they were forerunners.
You know, like let's face it, not very many people took yoga seriously and Eastern philosophy seriously until the Beatles went over with the yogi, and the next thing you knew, every media was talking about the Beatles, yogi, and then the advent of psychedelic influence into the music, make love not war, the flower power, and here we are so many years later, and what was being talked about in song is turning into reality.